नमस्ते टू एवरीवन, आई वेलकम यू ऑल इन माय यूट्यूब वीडियो चैनल। टुडे आई विल डिलीवर लेक्चर ऑन ग्रुप, लेक्चर नंबर 17, इन व्हिच आई विल डिस्कस सम थ्योरम्स एंड प्रॉब्लम्स ऑन ऑर्डर ऑफ एलिमेंट्स ऑफ ए ग्रुप। Now we shall prove a theorem. Theorem is each element of a finite group is of finite order. Let G be a finite group. This is finite group. So number of elements in G will be finite. Let A belongs to G. Then by closure law, A operation A belongs to G implies that A square belongs to G. Again, A square A belong to G implies that A square operation A belong to G implies that A cube belongs to G. Similarly, A square A cube dot 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 all are elements of G, but group is finite, so all the elements will not be distinct. It is necessary that AR equal to AS, because in this process we may get that if AR be any element, then after some step we will get AS an element such that AR equal to AS implies that AR operation A minus R equal to A S operation A minus R. Here R is less than S, implies that this is identity element and this is A to the power S minus R. Therefore, order of A less than equal to S minus R. S minus R is a finite quantity. Therefore, order of A is finite quantity. Since A be an arbitrary element of G, therefore, for any element of G, we get order of that element is finite, proved. Now, we prove the next theorem. Prove that the order of an element in a finite group cannot exceed the order of a group. Let G with given binary operation is a finite group. That means G has finite number of elements. Let A belongs to G. Then A operation A belongs to G let order of A equal to n implies that A to the power n equal to identity element, n be the least positive integers. Therefore, we get A square A to the power n equal to identity element, all are distinct elements of G. If possible, let A to the power R equal to A to the power S, where R is greater than equal to 1, less than equal to S, and S is less than N, implies that A to the power R operation A to the power minus R equal to A to the power S operation A to the power minus R. Left side is identity element equal to A to the power S minus R. Let this is number 1, this is number 2. Since here we see that R and S both are less than N, that means S minus R less than N. Here A to the power N equal to identity element, N be the least positive integer. Therefore, A to the power S minus R, where S minus R less than N, cannot be equal to identity element. That is, our assumption A to the power R equal to A to the power S is wrong. Therefore, A to the power R not equal to A to the power S. That means, all elements A, A square, A cube, ... A to the power N are distinct elements of G. Since G contains all these elements A, A square, ... A to the power N equal to identity element, also G contains some other elements except these elements. So, order of G means number of elements in G. If this is equal to M, let therefore this N is less than M, since these elements are also elements of G and G contains other elements also. And so N is less than equal to M. If G does not contain other elements, then G contains N number of elements. And if G contains other elements except these elements, then G contains M number of elements, that M is greater than N. Therefore, the order of G, this is order of G, is greater than equal to order of element A. That means order of an element in a finite group cannot exceed the order of the group G. Now we solve a problem. If order of an element A is less than 3, then A equal to inverse of A. Solution. Let case 1. Let order of A equal to 1 implies that A to the power 1 equal to identity element, implies that A equal to identity element, implies that A operation A equal to E operation E, implies that A operation A equal to identity element. Therefore, A is inverse of A, that is A equal to A inverse. Case 2. Let order of A equal to 2 implies that A square equal to identity element, implies that A operation A equal to identity element. That means A is the inverse of A. Therefore, A is the inverse of A. Proved. Now we solve a problem. If order of A is greater than equal to 3, then A and A inverse are distinct. Now we solve this. Solution. Let G be a finite set and A belongs to G. Case 1. Let order of A equal to 3 implies that A cube equal to identity element E. Since A square A cube equal to identity element, all are distinct elements. Now, A cube equal to identity element implies that A square operation A equal to A operation A square equal to identity element. Since A and A square are distinct elements, here A square is inverse of A. Therefore, we may write A square equal to A inverse. Hence, A and A inverse are distinct elements. Now, case 2. Let order of A equal to 4 implies that A to the power 4 is identity element. Since A square, A cube, A to the power 4 equal to identity element, all are distinct elements. Here, A to the power 4 equal to A operation A cube equal to A cube operation A, and A to the power 4 is identity element. Therefore, A cube be the inverse of A. Since A and A cube are
distinct elements. Therefore, A and A inverse are distinct elements. Case theory. Let order of A equal to N implies that A to the power N equal to identity element. N be the least positive integer. Since A square, A cube, dot 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 dot, A to the power N, all are distinct elements of G. And A to the power N equal to identity element implies that A operation A to the power N minus 1 equal to A to the power N minus 1 operation A equal to identity element. Therefore, A to the power N minus 1 be the inverse of A. That is, A to the power N minus 1 is inverse of A. Since A and A to the power N minus 1 are distinct element, therefore, A and A inverse are distinct elements of G. Now we solve a problem. If G with given binary operation be a finite group of even order, then prove that G contains odd number of elements of order 2. Now we solve this solution. Given that G be a group of finite order, but order of G is even number, we may get different types of elements in G. Firstly, some elements of G may have order greater than equal to 3. Let collection of all these elements be A. Second, let G has some elements whose order be 2. Let collection of these elements be B. And the group has identity element whose order is 1. Collection of this is C. Then A union B union C equal to G. Firstly, we discuss about the elements of A. Each element of A has order greater than or equal to 3. Let X belongs to A. Therefore, order of X is greater than or equal to 3. We know that order of inverse of an element is equal to order of that element. Therefore, X inverse, order of X inverse equal to order of X. So, X inverse belongs to A. Let we frame a set that is AX, which contains elements X and x inverse. So union of ax will be a. Therefore, we see that the set A will contains even number of elements, because if we take AX contains two elements, AY will contain two elements, and in this way 2 plus 2 plus 2 means even number of elements. Therefore, order of A equal to even. Order of C contains only one element, that is identity element. The order of C is 1. Then we have to calculate order of B. Since order of G equal to order of A plus order of B plus order of C. Order of G is even. This is even. This is even. Plus order of B. This is 1. That means if we take even minus even this side, order of B plus 1, even minus even is even, and if we take 1 this side minus 1, order of B, even minus 1 is odd, order of B. Therefore, B contains odd number of elements, and each element of B is of order 2. Therefore, the odd number of elements of order 2 will be odd. Proved. Now, I am giving the details of the lecture notes. Thanks for watching my video. If you are satisfied with my presentation and contents, then please click on like button and do subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you.